Welcome back to my channel, and in today's video I'll be telling you guys the 7 causes of hair breakage and how you can combat hair breakage and make your hair grow longer. So if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, make sure you do so. Click on the red subscribe button below and turn on the notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. So right now we're going to wait for you guys for 5 seconds so that you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. So right now we are waiting. Please subscribe. Subscribe. So welcome back. I'm going to take it that you have subscribed to our YouTube channel and you've also clicked on the notification bell so that whenever we post more hair videos like this, you will be notified that we have posted a new video. So now I'll go ahead and tell you the 7 causes of hair breakage, and the number 5 is the most important. So keep watching and try to make sure you get that number 5, because I see a lot of you making that mistake, and that is why most of your hair is finding it hard to grow. So keep watching and watch till the number 5 at least, guys. Stay tuned and please try to watch the whole video because it is very important. So I'll be going ahead now to tell you the number 1 cause of hair breakage and explain it to you and tell you how you can prevent your hair from breaking. So number 1 will be lack of moisture. When you don't moisturize your hair, that will lead to hair breakage. You need to moisturize your hair. And what I mean by moisturizing your hair can be just using only plain water to spray on your hair, or if you want to add more things to your moisturizer, you can add water, aloe vera gel, and probably castor oil to your spray bottle. Make sure you get yourself a spray bottle so that you can be using it to moisturize your hair every morning and whenever you want to go to bed. And make sure you are moisturizing your hair properly, massaging to your scalp when you spray your hair with the water, make sure you massage it into your scalp, and then after doing that, then you seal in those moisture with butter like shea butter. But make sure you apply the water, your moisturizer, before sealing in those moisture with shea butter or whatever butter you have. So number 2 would be tension from styling. When you put too much tension from styling your hair will break. Like when you go to the salon to make your hair and the stylist, they are braiding your hair too tight. When you're pulling your hair too tight, that would lead to hair breakage. And before you know it, you will start losing your edges. Your edges will start disappearing and you will start wondering, how can I grow back my edges? Well, they say prevention is better than cure. So any stylist that is braiding your hair too tight, please make sure to tell that him or her that the hair is too tight, that you don't need the hair to be tight. There is nowhere it is written that tight hair will make your hair grow very long. No, tight hair will damage your hair. It can cause you traction and alopecia, and you will lose your hair, and you don't want that because it will be hard for you to grow back your hair. So make sure you're not styling your hair too tight. And our number 3 tip is avoid heat. When you use too much heat to your hair, it will cause you heat damage, and you don't want heat damage on your hair. When you're using too much heat on your hair, like going to the salon, I know most of you like to stretch your hair. When you stretch your hair with heat, it might damage your hair. You might get heat damage, especially those of us with natural hair. It will damage your hair. And you want your hair your natural hair looking bouncy, and so that you can stretch it. When you stretch it, it will bounce back. That is exactly what you want. You don't want to go stretch your hair and when it's time for it to go back to its normal form, like you pour it water and then it won't go back to its normal form. That is what we call heat damage. Stop stretching, using high heat to stretch your hair, because when you start using high heat to stretch your hair, it will cause damage to your hair. So our number 4 cause of hair breakage is improper detangling. When you don't detangle your hair the proper way, it will lead to hair breakage. Like you just take down a protective style and then you don't moisturize your hair, and then you start detangling it or combing it with a small tooth comb. No, that is not the proper way to detangle your hair. If you detangle your hair that way, it will lead to hair breakage. Your hair will break really bad and you don't want that. So the proper way to detangle your hair is by dividing your hair in four sections and moisturizing it. Make sure you moisturize it with water-based products. Moisturize it with your water and your leave-in conditioner, or you can moisturize it with aloe vera. Aloe vera makes it easy for you to penetrate, for your big tooth comb to penetrate into your hair. So make sure you use your moisturizer, spray it on your hair. After you finish sectioning your hair, spray the moisturizer to your hair and then section your hair into, cut your hair into four sections and then start combing. Comb your hair from the tip, comb it little by little to remove those strand knots on your hair. Start combing it from the tip and down to the roots. You don't comb it from the roots down to the tip. You comb it little by little from the tip down to the root. So that way you won't lose much hair. You won't experience much breakage if you do it that way. So make sure you comb from the tip down to the root. So our number four, cause of hair breakage is too much protein. It is too much protein, and I see a lot of people doing this. Too much protein treatment. Yeah, protein treatment is good for your hair, but if you overdo it, then you will have protein overload, and you don't want that for your hair. Because when you have too much protein overload on your hair becomes dry, and you don't want that. When your hair is dry, it will be prone to breakage. It will easily break off, and you don't want that. So make sure you are not doing too much protein treatment. Like a lot, like a protein treatment I know a lot of you misuse is the rice water treatment. Rice water treatment is a protein treatment, and if you overuse it, if you overuse the rice water treatment on your hair, it will damage your hair. Like, so I see some people using the rice water treatment for a whole straight 1 week. No, it will dry out your scalp, and when your hair is dry, it will cause breakage. Don't use the rice water treatment for a straight 1 week. No, make sure if you're using the rice water treatment, you can at least, highest you can use that treatment is 2 times in a week. Do not extend it, please. I know a lot of you want to use that remedy to grow your hair, but please do not overuse it. If you overuse it, you will cause damage to your hair. I know you want to use it to grow your hair, but like I said, if you overuse it, you will do more harm to your hair than good. So avoid the protein treatment. So our number five here, that it is very important, that I'm sure most of you don't know, is using harsh chemicals on your hair. I know where you have a natural hair and you might be wondering how, what harsh chemical apart from relaxer am I using on my hair? No, harsh chemical doesn't only mean relaxer. Your shampoo, you need to check the ingredients of your shampoo before you use it. If your shampoo contains harsh ingredient like sulfate is a sulfate will dry your hair. It's a harsh chemical for our natural hair. It will dry out your hair. I know sulfate is like a if you're using a sulfate shampoo, then I see that as a clarifying shampoo. I use that once in, I only use a sulfate shampoo on my hair once in a month. And why I use it, because sulfate helps to clean the scalp really well, but it is not good to be using it every day or every week to shampoo your hair, because it will dry out your hair and dry out that your the natural oil from your scalp. You know our hair has a natural oil on our scalp that helps to keep our hair moisturized. You don't want the sulfate in your shampoo to dry out your hair, because honestly, sulfate in shampoo or in conditioner will really dry out your hair. So buy a sulfate free shampoo. When you're going to buy a shampoo, make sure you look at the ingredients on your shampoo, because they always list it out. So make sure you look at it and make sure there's no sulfate in your shampoo. You don't want a sulfate shampoo. You need a mild shampoo that will be good for your hair, that will keep your hair moisturized, that doesn't contain sulfate. because sulfate will dry out your hair. So our last tip, our last cause of hair breakage is ponytail holder and hair pins. I see a lot of you people making that mistake, putting your hair in a ponytail in a very tight way, like you hold your hair back really, really tight using a rubber band. No, rubber band will break your hair. Like most of you, when you use that rubber band on your hair, then you see your hair. When you pack it with your the rubber band, then later when pulling out that rubber band, you will notice the rubber band will also pull some of your hair strands. You will see some of your hair on the rubber band. Rubber band is not the thing you should be using to hold your hair back whenever you want to put your hair in a ponytail. Get a band. There are those black bands that are bigger that you can use to put your hair in a ponytail. And when you're putting your hair in a ponytail, make sure you are not pulling your hair back too tight, because when you pull your hair, you add tension to the front of your hair. You're pulling your hair too back. That will cause breakage to your hair, and you don't really want that at all, because when you're having breakage to your hair is won't grow the way it's supposed to. So avoid pulling your hair. Avoid too much tension on your hair. If you feel the ponytail is too tight to the extent it's giving you headache, please take it off. Lose it. You don't want your hair too tight. You're trying to grow your hair. You're not trying to cause damage to your hair. So please take it down or reduce the pressure from your hair. So I hope with this 7 causes of breakage that I've listed for you and the tips I've given you to prevent it, you will put them into practice and be consistent with it. Please note all these 7 causes of breakage that I gave to you, and please make sure you learn from it. So guys, if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, please click on the subscribe button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and click on the notification bell so that you'll be notified whenever we post a new video to our channel, because I'll be posting a lot of hair talks and how you can grow your hair on this channel. So guys, stay tuned and keep watching. Love you guys. Bye.